When taking a photo, the cameraman simply pushes a button and then comes a flash. Have you ever wondered how this photo flash comes about? Well, the photo flash is possible because of the storehouse of energy we shall call a capacitor. This device we are calling a capacitor is a storehouse of energy which releases the energy quickly during the short period of the flash. In this tutorial, we get to explore this device called the capacitor. Thanks for tuning in. This is Kisembo Academy. Now, what exactly is a capacitor? It is simply a passive two-terminal device which is used to temporarily store electrical charge. In our diagram here, we have a diagram of a capacitor. These are the two terminals we are talking about. Now, these two terminals are connected to two conductive plates. There is that plate that we are seeing on the top. There is that place that we are, the plate at the bottom. And in between is an insulator. And this insulator is what we are calling the dielectric. Now, the dielectric material can either be air, it can either be paper, or it can even be oil. And then also, these metal plates can either be square, they can be circular, they can be rectangular, or they can even be cylindrical, all depending on its application and the voltage rating. This is the cross-sectional view of the basic structure of a capacitor, this being the dielectric and the two plates we are talking about. And then this is a schematic diagram. This is how it appears, the symbol, when you're drawing it in an electric circuit. So let's look at how we charge this capacitor. Now here, when we are charging a capacitor, we are having this diagram here that will become the basis for our explanations on how we charge and discharge a capacitor. In this, we have a resistor, we have an ammeter, we have the capacitor here, we have a source of voltage, which we've labeled V0. Then we have a switch. This switch key can either be connected to terminal 1 or terminal 2. When it is connected to terminal 1, it would mean that the circuit is like that. So it would mean that if switch key is connected to terminal 1, it means this lower part of the circuit is out. Then if we connected this switch key to terminal 2, it would mean this upper part of the circuit is out. And we only have this, that one down. So we are going to look at how both work out. When we want to charge this capacitor, it means we are going to connect it to terminal 1 so that it gets charged. It gets its charge charged with electrons being put. It gets charged when it is connected to terminal 1 because it's in the upper circuit that we are having a source voltage. Now, if you want to discharge this capacitor, we will connect it to terminal 2 and it will get discharged. Now, let's exactly explain what happens during the charging process and the discharging process. So, we will begin with the charging process. The charging process is when we connect switch K to terminal 1. And that is, it's what we have here. This is switch K according to our diagram. Switch K has been connected to terminal 1. That's it. This is the switch K we are talking about. It has been connected to terminal 1. And so that means that the lower circuit is out of the picture. Explaining the charging process. Now, electrons flow from the negative terminal of the battery, which is that one, to this plate Y. Why do they flow? Of course, this being negative terminal, the electrons will be repelled. And when they are repelled, it means they are going to concentrate on this plate, and so this plate Y will become negatively charged. Likewise, this being a positive terminal of the battery, it is going to attract electrons from this plate X. And so electrons will be attracted towards place the positive terminal and leaving an excess of positive charges here. So it means that plate X becomes positively charged, plate Y becomes negatively charged. Now, as these charges accumulate on these plates, the potential difference across these plates starts increasing. Now, as the potential difference across these plates increases, the amount of current that is going to be flowing through the ammeter also starts decreasing. So it is such that when the potential difference across this plate increases to the point whereby the PD across these plates of the capacitor is equivalent to the PD across the cell, then it would mean that this capacitor has been fully charged and so there will be no flow of electrons. I mean, the flow of electrons will cease. This is explained in our graph of current against time. When we look at this graph of our current against time, initially the current is very high. The flow of electrons, or the current from the cell, is very high. But as the charging process continues, the amount of current goes on decaying as the potential difference across the plates of this capacitor gets on increasing. So the current decreases up to zero. So it means that at this point in time, the potential difference across the plates of the capacitor is equivalent to the potential difference or the EMF of that cell. And so at that point, the charging of this capacitor has been complete, and so no current flows. Let's look at how the potential difference across the capacitor plates varies with time. When we are charging this capacitor, the PD across the plates of this capacitor at first is zero. So as the charging continues, the PD across this capacitor increases, and as it increases, it reaches the maximum. It reaches the maximum voltage and the charging stops. The charging gear is going to be, the capacitor will be fully charged when the potential difference across this cell is equivalent to the EMF of that cell. And at that point, current stops flowing. The ammeter is no longer deflecting, meaning current is not flowing anymore. Now let's explain the discharging process. Looking at the discharging process, we are now connecting switch K. Previously, switch K was being connected to point 1. Now we are connecting switch K to terminal 2. That is what we are seeing here. Switch K is being connected to terminal 2. When switch K has been connected to terminal 2, remember, in this part of the circuit, there is no source of EMF. We are just having two plates that are charged that are being connected to a resistor and to some circuit. So when that happens, it means electrons are going to flow from plate Y, and they will flow to come and discharge this plate X. So what does that mean? It means that the potential difference across the capacitors at first is very high, but as these electrons flow from plate Y to come to discharge or to neutralize plate X, it means that the potential difference across this capacitor will decrease. When the potential difference across this capacitor decreases, it means that this capacitor is also going to lose its energy. So that is how it gets discharged. Looking at the current also flowing through this ammeter at first is high when the electrons are traveling to come and discharge the X plates, but as time goes on, the current decays to zero. And when the current that is flowing through the ammeter decays to zero, it would mean that the capacitor has been fully discharged. Let's look at how these parameters vary on the graph. Looking at the voltage against time, we said that during the discharging process, at first when we connect switch K to 2, the voltage is very high. Then these electrons start flowing to come and neutralize the positive charges on the X plate. So when that happens, the voltage starts dropping up to when the voltage decays to zero. And when the voltage decays to zero, it means that the capacitor has been completely discharged. Let's examine how current is going to vary during the discharging process. Now, during the discharging process, when the voltage again across this is too high, it's going to mean that the current that is going to flow will be high at first. But then as time goes on, the current is going to be very high. But this flow of current is in the opposite direction. Remember, previously, during the charging process, if this is the flow of electrons, it means that our current flows in the opposite direction to flow of electrons. So current was flowing in that direction through the ammeter. It was entering the ammeter from this side, moving like that. The flow of current, that is charging. Now when we changed the terminals and we connected it to terminal 2, that is now during the discharging process, It means that the electrons on this plate are going to travel in this direction, meaning current will travel in the opposite direction. So it means that when we are plotting our, in according to our graph, the current is first going to be high, but it is traveling in the negative direction. That's why the graph is at the negative part. But then as these electrons move and continue to neutralize this plate, it will decay to zero. So that's all about the discharging process of a capacitor. R times C is going to give us a certain constant we are going to call the time constant. Now, this constant is what categorizes or it what characterizes the rate of charging and discharging of the capacitor. So it means that if R, or the resistance that is in the circuit, is small, or if the capacitance of the capacitor in the circuit is small, it means that this constant here is going to be small. And if that constant is small, it means that the rate of charging and discharging of the capacitor will be faster. If the resistance is very high and all the capacitance is also very high, it means that if we multiply those two, it's going to give us a time constant that is very high. So when the time constant is very high, it's going to simply mean that the rate of charging and discharging of that capacitor is going to also be, it's going to be slow. So if you want to watch more of this video, I encourage you to subscribe to this channel. And for the benefit of your colleagues out there that would like to watch more of these tutorials, simply share this video. Otherwise, thanks for watching and hope to catch you in the next video. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Ranga Kurambi.